Okay, here we have a 2009 Volkswagen T1 with 50,000 miles. And of course, it has a full random misfire. I just want to show you guys, you know, how that looks inside the manifold. Get some light in a second. That is what you have to clean, and the only right way to do it is taking the manifold apart and do it manually. I mean, that is the problem with the GDI systems. They just fill the intake valve with carbon deposits, you know, from the PCB valve system, you know, reader system. So it's, you just gotta take a pick, clean it, put, you know, carbon cleaner, gum out, whatever you need to do, and just clean it. It's the only way. So it's a short video, but that's the way it is. Pretty basic to remove the intake. So just a couple of wiring that you have to be careful and remove. You have to remove the throttle body first. The intake hose that goes to the intercooler on the bottom. And then that's it. I will probably add a video on when I'm installing the back and when this is clean. Sorry for always putting short videos, but you know how the shop work is. I wish I had more time to record video for you guys, but well, I'm starting to just doing it, so hope you like it. Okay, now back with the T1. I already cleaned the intake packets. Yeah, I'll show you. Okay, with the how they look now. Let's see if I can get the light better. Yeah, so it's not as bright, but you can see the packet. Okay, that's better. You can see I removed all the carbon deposits from both sides. It's very nice and clean, all of them. What I do is I keep the valves closed, and I use a pick to remove as much as, you know, the carbon. Then I blow air, you know, and then at last I bring the valves down. Like this piston number two, I clean the bottom of the valves with carbon cleaner and gum cutter. And then I blow air to make sure I dry everything. For sure, we need to do an oil change on this, but that's how you do it. One other thing I wanted to show is this GDI injector, sometimes they get stuck into the cylinder head. Very important to have the right instructor for this. Let me show you that. I got mine from a Snap-on. Very, very, very good tool. You don't want to break one of those injectors, and that's going to be very expensive. So this is the extractor. Very simple. In this case, I have a problem with injector number one. You see that this hole by pressure, you know, with the O-ring on this fuel rail. But in order to remove it, let's say, you know, this is, you gotta put them in the cylinder head so you guys can see. This one got very, very stuck in there. But I said, the injector is in there with that position, it stays in there, no problem at all. So what you gotta do is just make sure you get inside. Make sure you have that, this has an opening, as you can see here, for like the connection. That's all you gotta be careful with. So you put one side in, and the other side, and then you slide the ring down. And all you gotta do is just tap it back, stop, and it will come out like this. So, see, this is how it looks, this bowl. It's very, very handy tool, and it's a must have if you're gonna be doing this kind of job. Alright, we'll probably take some more video on the installation. I might set up a tripod and let you guys see it, but I'm putting everything back together. I don't have the parts, you know, the intake gasket and O-rings for the injectors, but at least everything is nice and clean. So we'll get back with the installation. Alright?